I'd like to give a big shout out to my little subscribers. It's the Sugar Babe. They're Paisley and Coop.
Now this is the video when all come together with our DIY wheel holder here. And also the coupler holder. Now, you got this from the train show a couple weeks ago. And, you know, the coupler's a little beat up there. Plastic, you know, a little beat up. And the wheels, also plastic there with a, I guess, a brass axle. But we're going to switch those out with metal wheels that weather that we did. So, let's get to the tools that I'll be using here today. It's from a Michael Mart. There's the item number there if you want to stop and pause. And we'll start popping off these wheels. Now here we have actual coal. This has been sifted already. This is just a large chunks that then go through the screens that I had. So I got three different classes. This is MK class 3, so it's so big. Have a class 2 here. You can see it. I'm gonna put, take some out for you. I'm call this class 2. And we're gonna go with a class 1, which is super, super fine. That's the fine I can get. But we'll show you in a little bit. So basically, I already got a coal load already in this car that I got from that purchase I did, that train show, which was pretty cool. And I used that as my base. Take some white glue, almost white glue. And I'm just gonna basically paint or cover this coal load here. You know, it looks fine, but I got real coal and I want to use my real coal. Paint it on here. It ain't gotta be too pretty. See that is all covered here. And we're gonna go with our class 1, which is super fine. We're basically gonna sprinkle in it. Here you have your desired height. So we try to shape it just a little bit. Using a fan brush, brush it up. Now, this just, you know, how I'm experimenting doing it. You know, there's many ways to do this, but just showing you how I went about doing it. And I'm quite sure there's other techniques to get it done, but I kind of found it's worked for me. And you know, I'm learned by trial and error. Let me get a spray here with my Willix Senior Cement, and I'm gonna shoot over it, then come down, as because I want to disturb the shape of the coal load here. And notice I did a lot of cars already. Here, just show you guys. Nah, I didn't. With the spray, nice and easy, because it will move it slightly. Gonna move this a little bit. I'm gonna take my time at first. Get nice and wet. Now see that's starting to soak inside there, and it's not moving as it first started. So now I can just go on the spray as much as I need, because it got to soak all the way down to the bottom, to where that load already was at, to keep it secure, or you know, make it one piece. Completely saturated, and we just gotta wait till it dries. It'll take quite a while to dry, to be honest with you, because it gotta soak through all that material and dry. Now here's the coal loads here that they're dry. Zoom in a little bit, you can see some of it. I did go touch it up a little bit, add a little bit more coal on the top, because I like my coal cars be overflowing. That's how I like them, to each his own. I just want to show you how I do it, and you can take what I use and bring it to your own. So to give it a more authentic feel, I'm going to add real cool dust onto these cars. So all you gotta do, what I'm doing is just fixing this coal on this brush, just brush it on in. You can see that it'll leave some coal here on the ribs of the car, and I like that effect. They'll give it a little more realism, like some coal fell off and then land on the side of the car. And also see the dust filling the little cracks here also. And the reason why I like that, because I have seen it when I do coal trains here in New Jersey, and I think it's pretty cool. So I'm just cleaning this up a little bit. Let's bring that down, make some soft strokes. And another way of doing this, I just a brushed in one. You also can take handfuls and just pour it on there. So this is the effect if you just throw it on there, swipe it a little bit. Pretty cool effect, man. Let's try the edges. That we painted up in a $2 jig, and also one of the $2 wheel jig also. So we're gonna add the couplers onto this in the weather. Of course, we use a real coal. This is the coarse, and I have fine cars, and I have really big chunks in other cars. I just see what I like. So here we go.